Welcome to Gartex Electronics. Today we shall learn on how to use a Triac device. I will try to make this tutorial as simple as possible. Triac's main purpose is to be used in the switching of AC voltages. In our previous tutorials we learned that, a Triac is a bidirectional thyristor with three terminals, namely Main Terminal 1, Main Terminal 2, and the gate. In other words, a Triac can be regarded as two conventional silicon-controlled rectifiers connected in inverse parallel in such a way that they share a single gate terminal. A Triac can be used as a solid-state switch that is normally off and can be turned on by applying a suitable voltage or current signal at its gate terminal. How a Triac works. 1. Normally, when no gate signal is applied, the Triac is off and Main Terminal 1 and Main Terminal 2 acts as an open switch. 2. If a positive or a negative signal is applied at the gate, the Triac is switched on irrespective of the polarities at its main terminals. This means that the Main Terminal 1 and Main Terminal 2 now acts as a closed switch. Hence, current is allowed to flow to the load. 3. Once the Triac has been turned on via the gate signal, it self-latches and continues to be on as long as the main terminal currents continue to flow. Note that only a brief signal at the gate is required to turn on the Triac. 4. Once the Triac is self-latched, the gate terminal loses its control over the Triac and the Triac can only be turned off again by momentarily reducing its terminal currents below minimum zero. If the Triac is used as an AC power switch, the turn-off of the Triac occurs automatically at zero crossing point at the end of each half cycle as the main terminal currents fall to zero. 5. When the Triac is switched on, it has a saturation potential of 1 volt or 2 volts developed across its main terminals. Hence, if the Triac is used to switch on a 10 ampere load from a 240 volts AC load, the Triac has a saturation potential of 1.5 volts, approximately 2,400 watts can be switched by the Triac. Only 15 watts of power is lost in the Triac itself. This 15 watts can be readily be dissipated as heat by connecting the Triac to a suitable heatsink. Hence, Triac is a suitable AC power switch. Having reminded ourselves about basic characteristics of a Triac and how it works, let us now examine how a Triac can be connected as a C-line power switch. The load is connected in series with the Triac's main terminals irrespective of the AC line polarities. This means that main terminal 1 is connected to the load and the other main terminal 2 is connected to the AC supply. Or, main terminal 2 is connected to the load and main terminal 1 is connected to the other terminal of AC line supply. Therefore, the other terminal of the load is connected to the remaining terminal of AC supply line as shown here. Today we shall build a simple but powerful light dimmer circuit, which uses a Triac as a switch to switch on and off lights. This project is simple and cheap to make, so you don't have to worry so much about the money. Selecting a Triac. In this project we are going to use BTA16 Triac series, which is suitable for general purpose mains power AC switching, and it is available in through hole and surface mount packaging. This Triac can be used as on-off function in applications such as static relays, heating regulation or induction motor starting circuit. They are also recommended for phase control operations in light dimmers and appliance motors speed controllers. As usual, let us search for the BTA16 datasheet in the internet. Then download the datasheet and study it carefully, noting the BTA16 pinout and power ratings. BTA16 pinout. Pin 1 is the main terminal 1, T1. Pin 2 is the main terminal 2, T2. Pin 3 is the gate, G. Pin 4 should not be connected. BTA16 ordering information. The following figure is BTA16 ordering information. BT stands for Triac series. Letter A stands for insulation and sometimes can be substituted with letter B, which means non-insulated. 16 stands for 16 amperes. Connect the main terminal 1 to neutral line of 240 volts AC power supply. Then connect main terminal 2 of the Triac to the load. Next, connect the load to the live line of 240 volts AC power supply. Connect the gate terminal to a Triac as shown. Then connect the other terminal of the Triac to resistor 1, then to variable resistor, and join the variable resistor to resistor 2, and then connect to the main terminal 2. Connect capacitor 2 between main terminal 1 and the variable resistor. Lastly, connect an inductor, the switch, and capacitor 1 as shown in the diagram. Please study carefully how I have connected the components in this circuit. The Triac is used as a trigger device that fires when voltage of capacitor 2 rises to roughly 35 volts in either polarity and partially discharges capacitor 2 into Triac gate, thus triggering the Triac on. The Triac then switches off immediately when the voltage of capacitor 2 falls below 30 volts and so on. The light dimmer project works on 240 volts AC directly, and if you are not accustomed to working with mains voltage or do not have experience in working with 240 volts AC mains voltage, please stay away from this project while it is connected with main power. Now you can test your light dimmer by adjusting the variable resistor accordingly. In this tutorial, we have focused on how to connect a Triac and we used a light dimmer circuit as an example. In upcoming tutorials, we shall discuss in detail about Triacs, inductors, and commercial light dimmer circuits.
Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe to this channel for more video updates. Bye.